much. My name is Jim Monroe. I am the president of the Pine Bluff Community Band, and I'm your announcer for this evening. We always enjoy coming out here to Trinity Village because every concert season, you guys are the first one in our concert series, so we're always glad to be here. And so thank you for being here tonight, because it's folks like you that make our rehearsal time worthwhile. So thank you guys for being here. We have a variety of music for you tonight. We have a march, a big band tune, a couple of movie themes, and not one, but two tunes saluting those four lads from Liverpool. So we almost always begin each concert with a march, and tonight is no different. Well, during his lifetime, John Philip Sousa was rightfully named the March King, and he's still called that some 90 years after his death. He composed 137 marches, 15 operettas, and a host of other works during his 77-year life. Now, in case you don't know, an operetta is similar to an opera, but it's shorter and it's less serious. It includes dialogue and it's usually satirical. The operetta is the precursor to what we know as a musical today. Well, his most successful operetta was called El Capitan, and it was first performed in April of 1896. It was about the Viceroy of Peru, who learns that insurgents have hired a hitman named El Capitan to remove him from office. And learning that El Capitan has died, the Viceroy disguises himself as El Capitan and goes over to the enemy. And all kinds of complications follow, of course. So we hope you enjoy John Philip Sousa, El Capitan. But first, please welcome our director. He's been our director for, it seems like, 150 years now, Jerry Williams. Classic storyline of a young man falling in love with a beautiful local girl, then having to choose between his passion for his career, which was filmmaking, and the love of a woman. He decided to leave his small town and pursue his passion of making films at the expense of losing the girl of his dreams. Well, the film is quite emotional, and you can feel that emotion reflected in the theme from that movie, which is our next tune. You may not be familiar with the movie, Cinema Paradiso, but you'll most likely recognize the movie's theme. Tells us some, but not a lot really, about heaven. So I don't know if there's some kind of railing of some kind that our loved ones can lean over and kind of see what's going on here, but we hope that that Ross is listening and appreciates every time that we play Gary Henson's arrangement of
Thank you.
7 minutes and 20 seconds, just like that. All right, well, the Quarrymen was a British musical group formed by John Lennon in 1956. Paul McCartney joined in 1957 and 14-year-old George Harrison in 1958. In 1960, the group changed its name to what? The Beatles. Yeah, there you go. A name that sounded like an insect, right? But spelled a little bit differently, but it was also a wink to Buddy Holly's band. And who is Buddy Holly's band? You can reply. Buddy Holly and the Crickets. There you go. So it was kind of a wink to that group as well. Now, Richard Starsky, better known as Ringo Starr, he joined in 1962. And by the way, Ringo Starr and his all-star band performed in Little Rock just a couple of weeks ago. So, well, these four lads from Liverpool would eventually personify the counterculture of the 1960s. Now, of the four members of the Beatles, John Lennon and Paul McCartney were the creative force behind the group's success in the 60s and early 70s. Our first tribute to the Fab Four tonight is a tune entitled Lennon-McCartney Portrait. Arranger Bill Holcomb has put together four of their most popular songs, Hard Day's Night, And I Love Her, Day Tripper, and Hey Jude. Now ladies, I have a special request for you. Please restrain yourself, okay? I don't want you to get too excited like you probably did when they first performed on the Ed Sullivan Show back in 1964. So we do hope you enjoy our playing of Lennon-McCartney Portrait.
Thank you.
Goss will take a standing ovation anytime. Anytime. Well, thank you very much. Thank you very much. Hopefully, you were able to recognize some of those tunes. I think I heard some singing go along while we were playing. That's great. Please do that. Well, In the Mood is one of the most popular big band era jazz standards ever. The song was not written by Glenn Miller, but he did purchase it in 1939, the same year that he and his band recorded it. In 1983, that recording was inducted into the Grammy Hall of Fame. And in 2004, the recording was inducted into the Library of Congress National Recording Registry, which consists of recordings that are culturally, historically, or aesthetically significant. It's also on National Public Radio's list of the 100 most important musical works of the 20th century. So your Pine Bluff Community Band is honored to perform this catchy and historically significant tune, In the Mood. Leonard Bernstein, and the arrangement we will be performing tonight is by Michael Sweeney. The order in which you will hear the tunes are, the selections are Prologue, Maria, Tonight, One Hand, One Heart, America, and Somewhere. So now, selections from West Side Story.
Thank you.
Jack's portrayal of Captain Jack Sparrow puts fun and humor into piracy. So there are currently 5 movies in this film series, so it has obviously been quite successful for the Walt Disney Company. This set of tunes is from the first movie called The Curse of the Black Pearl and includes the following tunes: Fog Bound, The Medallion Calls to the Cave, The Black Pearl, One Last Shot, and He's a Pirate. You may not be familiar with the movie, but I think when you hear the songs, it'll put you into that pirating mood. So we hope you enjoy our playing of some of the tunes from Disney's Pirates of the Caribbean.
Thank you.
Cats from Across the Pond is a tune we played here before. It's a medley of songs from Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band album. It was the 8th studio album by the Beatles, and both the musical style of the songs as well as the album cover artwork was quite eclectic. The varied musical influences are evident in the songs, including vaudeville, circus, music hall, avant-garde, and Indian classical music. In 1968, the album won 4 Grammy Awards, including Album of the Year, the first rock LP to receive such an honor. More than 32 million copies of the album has been sold, making it one of the best-selling albums of all times. The order of the songs from this album that we'll be playing tonight are Lucy in the Sky with Diamonds, Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band, When I'm 64, or in some of our cases, when we were 64. She's Leaving Home, and With a Little Help from My Friends. So as our final tune tonight, as the lyrics of Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band state, we hope you will enjoy the show, so sit back and let the evening go.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. We enjoyed being here. Thank you, Ms. Coffey, for inviting us and having us.